Now I would like to call Ghulam Mustafa upon the stage for his speech.
They want us to write in blood and only write of peace. They capture our land, make us sour eyes that is not seed, kill us, rape. They tell us we are ungrateful, like children who don't see what is good for them, holding us with many kinds of guns. They grimace at the world, calling our blood on their faces, vermilion. They sell pens, we buy with blood. Many of them from their mythical land comes to us. Many of them from their mythical land comes to us. They meet our eyes that gaze. That gaze. Behind their orange irises you see wheels turning like the innards of a Swiss watch. Precise, surgical. They sell paper. We buy with blood. They put the kettle on boil. It whistles. The seduction of tea. There is no better heaven. Our pens poised. The next world will liberate. 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 Meanwhile, Ashfaq is no more. Makbul has gone. Asiya and Nilofar raped, then killed. Afzal hanged. Tufail buried in two graves. Atar Salar in Lal Chowk disappeared. They found his bones with empty bottles. They found his bones with empty bottles. The kettle whistles. The tea never comes. Our bones are made tired, waiting. Before the door of love from that overused Kafka tale, the only thing that grows after this wait are their swords, looming mightier. And this too, we write, my lord, we write. They exhort us to write in blood and only write of peace. Of tulip gardens they grew on soils, made fertile with our flesh and with our bones. And this too, we write when they are at war with us. Mr. President, sir, the people of Jammu and Kashmir are being killed, maimed, tortured and jailed. They are being haunted, wounded and humiliated for reminding India and international community to fulfill their pledges made to the Kashmiri people. The United Nations, despite being aware about disappointing, dismal and shameful track record of human rights violation in Indian occupied Kashmir by Indian brutal forces, has failed to impress upon India to run in its trigger happy soldier and stop killings in the state. Custodial killings, enforced disappearances and rape as a weapon of war are the hallmarks of Indian occupation forces. All the civil rights and all the basic rights and civil liberties have been snatched by Indian occupation forces. Mr. President, sir, there is no freedom of expression and there is no freedom of assembly. Peaceful protesters are being responded by brute forces. Bullets and pellets are used against the peaceful protesters. Bullets and pellets are being used against the peaceful protesters. Indian army forces are present in every nook and every corner, thus turning Jammu and Kashmir into a virtual prison. Kashmir, once called a paradise on earth, has become a place of misery, sorrow, death and destruction, my lord, destruction. Mr. President, sir, on November 26, 2018, 19 months old Hibba Nisar faced pellet injuries in her eyes. She was neither a militant nor a terrorist. On the very same day, Indian Army martyred 6 innocent Kashmiris while branding them as terrorists. On December 15, 2018, Indian Army martyred 11 innocent Kashmiris in southern Pulwama district of Indian occupied Kashmir. Indian Army labeled 3 of them as militants, 1 as soldier and 7 as protesters. So-called Indian intelligence agencies martyred PhD students while branding them as terrorists. If this is humanity, then I reject, my lord, I reject. Ladies and gentlemen, do you remember Kushan Bhojpura? Do you remember? If raping of the Kashmiri women in the garb of search operation is humanity, then I reject, my lord. If killing of innocent Kashmiris is humanity, then I reject, my lord. If illegal detention of Kashmiri leaders is humanity, then I reject, my lord. I reject. Mr. President, sir, the Indian Army has literally converted the heavenly Kashmir into a hell. Unfortunately, the global community and the human and the champions of human rights has failed to impress upon India to rein in its trigger happy soldiers and stop killings in the state. Mr. President, sir, Kashmir is burning with bullets and pellets, and its suppression is condemnable. Why is civilized world silent? Why? It is questionable. It is questionable. Indian Constitution says that all the civil liberties, all the citizens shall have equal rights. All the citizens shall have equal rights to freedom of speech and to freedom of assembly. And when it comes to Kashmir, Indian Army forgets the Constitution and starts barbarity in the states. If this is humanity, then I reject, my lord. Then I reject. So it is clear that there is a big, big difference between Indian subject and Indian verb. To sum up, I will suggest, say no more Indian brutalities in Kashmir. Say no more human rights violations in Kashmir. Say no more India's crimes against humanity. Thank you very much.